Melbourne Grammar's openly gay school captain is taking on the Presbyterian Church. Daniel Cash has criticised the church for wanting to ban gay students from leadership roles at its schools, including Scotch College. Any student who's had sex before marriage would also be banned. The church claims it's because those students wouldn't be able to give appropriate Christian leadership.
Daniel Cash joins us now. Daniel, I understand you are not at a Presbyterian school, but how did you feel when you heard the Presbyterian Church's stance?
Well, to be honest, Waleed, it's quite shocking to me. I mean, I've had the good fortune of being raised in an environment and a school and with a family that's very inclusive and very accepting, and my whole journey I've been okay with who I am. So to see something like this in the Presbyterian Church is, well, it's shocking and confusing, and to be honest, it was met with, by me and by my peers too, a kind of confused awe, because my generation, one of its strongest points is its disinterest for sexuality in a very kind of gentle, accepting way. And yeah, so that disinterest, I think, has characterised the response that at least I have seen from my peers and from my friends, that kind of shock. For why the church would even believe that sexuality has a bearing on leadership or a bearing on the identity of students to a degree where you might discriminate in this way.
Well, Daniel, I understand that you're not religious. As far as the Presbyterian Church states in regards to a gay captain, it says it wouldn't be able to give appropriate Christian leadership in a Christian school which requires modelling Christian living. What do you make of that?
To be honest, I think it's, from my opinion, a very harmful and almost cruel reading of the Bible. I mean, the central teaching which Christ exemplified in his life is to love others as you yourself would like to be loved. So I see no fault in one's Christianity if they're a good person, if they're kind, and if they love others as they'd like to be loved. So something such as being gay, or as the submission made stipulates, having premarital sex, that has no bearing on the quality of your leadership or even on the quality of your identity. So I think that even people who aren't Christian can, in that sense, model Christian living if they practice integrity and they're good, decent people.
You're calling for the church to change its stance. Do you think this will happen?
Well, the Gospel of Luke tells us to be open and open-minded in reading Scripture, and I hope the church, the Presbyterian Church, can practice that. To be honest, I don't know the functions or the workings of the church. I'm a 17-year-old boy, and the fact that the Presbyterian Church has a 17-year-old in the newspaper and on air imploring them to change their mind and to perhaps exhibit the compassion that they teach, well, I hope that fact alone is enough to implore them to change, and I hope we can see that. But, yeah, I don't know.
Daniel, thanks so much for speaking to us tonight.
Thanks for having me.